Prepare your butts. The xTool Creative Space version 2.0 launch is imminent. And with that launch comes five new awesome features. What started out as extremely simple software to provide somewhat of a first-party experience with xTool devices has now morphed into a fully fledged baby. I mean, adult. Or wait, software package. I'm just leaving that in. I'm leaving it. While I've never really been a fan of proprietary software due to the fact that the company could basically brick your machine at any minute, I'm looking at you, Cricket. I do think that having that software available from a first-party perspective makes things really easy for new users to get in and running in the realm of lasers. Having third-party options like Lightburn and Laser Gerbil are awesome, but that first-party experience also means that the settings in the tool are going to be best optimized for the machine by the manufacturer. But I'll be honest, up until this point, I was only going to use Lightburn with my S1. That's the S1 over there. Isn't he pretty? I felt like the software was Fisher-Price my first laser, which is fine. It's just I was a more advanced user, so probably not the target audience. So let's go over the five brand new features that are coming in with version 2.0. First up, we have the Material Easy Set Library. The Easy Set Library is a new subsection of the xTool software. It can be accessed from a browser and in Creative Space. It has over 300 materials that xTool has tested for engraving, scoring, and cutting. Each material has its own page that shows you an interactable image of the test results at different speed and power values. Since not every laser is built the same, you can drop down from the available xTool machine models, laser powers, and processing types to see the output from that specific configuration. For example, there's a huge difference between a 20-watt D1 and a 20-watt S1. You can interact with the image to select the result that best suits your project, then click the Open in XCS button to import the settings and continue working. One of the processing options I was very happy to see offered is bitmap. If you want to do any kind of engraving involving a photo without converting it first into a black and white vector, these are the settings you'll want to get for the best results. Of all of the features to add to your software to make it easier for new people to get into laser engraving and cutting, that's it. Spending hours and materials and blood and sweat and tears to try to figure out what looks best for each material sucks. So to have at least a starting point offered from the first party software, big thumbs up from me. The second feature is Snapshot Preview. Since not all of the machines offered by xTool have a camera, you're probably wondering, how the heck can you have a Snapshot Preview? No, they're not offering a camera as an accessory that you can pay God only knows how much money for. They want you to use your phone. Based on the demonstration, all you have to do is lay down some target markers, snap a picture, calibrate the camera, and then you're done with calibration. You will not have to calibrate it again. From that point forward, all you have to do is snap pictures with your phone and send it over to your computer. Then Creative Space can use that information to give you an accurate representation of where your design is going to show up. I mean, this is really good for not wasting material, but can you imagine the batch processing capabilities? So in order to do any kind of batch processing right now, I had to create a jig, which then gets cut out and made into a physical jig for me to slot items into. Then I need to mimic the jig in the software and embed it into every single design as a template layer. So I'm sure people are like, yeah, sure, how accurate is this? Okay, look, they did a live stream like a couple of days ago, and they put this stuff on toothpicks. Toothpicks. The dude literally salt bayed toothpicks all over the laser bed, took a picture, and then they engraved very small text onto them. And while they openly admitted that some of the text was maybe a little too big for the toothpicks, the fact that it actually nailed it is killing me right now. Look at these flippin' toothpicks. The third feature is intelligent path planning. I'll be honest that when I used Creative Space before with my S1, I had a lot of issues with the pathing. Pathing is basically determinative. It's trying to figure out what is the best and fastest way to use the laser. In most cases, I actually found Lightburn to be faster with the current version of Creative Space. But now, xTool is saying that they can have some designs go 3 times faster than they did before. This might not sound like a big deal for your average user, but for me, and I do a lot of batch processing and things in bulk, it's Awesome. Feature number 4, vector node editing. Now this might sound like a no-brainer. Tons of apps allow you to edit the nodes on a vector graphic, so why not the Creative Space tooling? It basically sucks to have to open up a completely separate application to edit your design if it's something really simple that you need to change. So xTool added the ability to actually edit your vector graphics in the tool itself. That gives users an even bigger reason to stick to that software instead of opening up 2 or 3 other things to make a simple edit. And the 5th and final feature, managing multiple devices. Prior to this update, users could only talk to one xTool laser at a time. If you wanted to do more than one, you needed a second computer. Now, I only have the one, but could you imagine if I had something else like their fiber laser in here, which is the F1, and I wanted to do something with cutting fabric and then something with engraving some bag tags? If I had wanted to do that, I'd have to do it with my laptop and my main computer. But now they have added the ability to open up multiple canvases and have multiple projects connected to different machines and running them at the same time. This is a feature I really wish I had in Lightburn, because when I'm in my workshop and I'm working with the other lasers, yeah, it kind of sucks to only be able to do one laser at a time. So what are you looking forward to most out of that big old list of features that are coming? Leave your comments in the section below the video. As always, like the video, subscribe to the channel, blah, 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 bye.